welcome to Adobe Think Tank. Again, use hashtag AdobeTT if you want to follow along, ask some questions, and just hang out. With me is Lindsey Zuloaga, Data and Science, or Director of Data Science for HireVue. Thanks for joining me.
Thank you.
So, how should companies use AI to recruit and hire? Because we talk a lot about, you know, on the reverse side of it, you know, AI jobs and everything, but how can AI be used in the hiring process?
Yeah, so right now we're kind of in a situation where a lot of companies have high volume, even small companies. When they open up a position,
sure,
they get many hundreds of applications.
Oh, yeah, because you can apply to a job without wearing pants in the company.
Exactly.
Home. Makes it
right.
A little easy.
So a lot of, like, basically, the name of the game is just finding top talent faster. Like I said, traditional hiring methods are kind of slow. Recruiting and going through the whole hiring process is just kind of a, not really keeping up with the times as far as being in this connected global world. So companies that are using these AI tools are just snagging top talent right away off the market before these old-fashioned companies have really even had a chance to look at resumes.
Yeah.
So that's really what it's all about, is finding good talent as fast as possible.
Yeah, and I mean, a pretty well-circulated article now about how, you know, people coming out of MIT and big colleges, you know, have the ability to make $1.2 million coming out right now. But yeah, I mean, kind of give me your thoughts on that and where we are in almost like the supply and demand of like really technical positions.
Yeah, so there's a lot of demand for people who build AI tools, and there, at the same time, there are a lot of people who want to get into it.
Sure.
But there's kind of this gap with people who really have the skills. I think there's kind of, and maybe there will be two branches of data scientists in the future, but there are people who have like a really strong mathematical background,
right,
like having a PhD in math or physics or, you know, any STEM field. And then there are people who have done boot camps and they're really good at applying, using like Python or R to,
right,
solve real world problems. So they have this experience and they've played around with it quite a bit, but maybe not the deeper understanding. So go like kind of sifting through all those people and figuring out who's who can be tricky, but I think it's very likely that going forward there might become kind of two separate jobs, a little bit of a more applied data scientist,
right,
and then the bigger thinkers and designers of the underlying algorithms.
Well, I think as we progress in any field, right, you find a niche here, a niche there, a niche,
yep,
niche everywhere. How does AI kind of, I mean, this is kind of similar to the first question, but how does it affect the HR process, and kind of maybe tell me a little bit about what you guys do at HireVue?
Yeah, so we are a video interviewing platform. So our customers are companies. They create job interviews that have consistent questions, and they can send them out to many people.
Sure.
Those people can just record themselves on answering the questions at their own convenience,
yep,
and then submit them. So this kind of replaces the whole beginning of the funnel, like resume, phone screening steps.
Wonderful.
And yeah, I think it's great because when I was applying for jobs after I left academia, I felt like a resume was like a very poor representation of who I was as a person.
Oh, yeah.
And a lot of times I was submitting to applicant tracking systems and just never hearing anything back.
Right.
So,
and when you're sifting through volume of thousands and thousands,
exactly,
you almost, and actually, this is kind of an interesting question when we get into AI. As people use more of those models to kind of sift through, people can kind of get lost, right? So you're trying to create a system where, you know, it's easy to do, but you allow people to be seen and heard and not, you know, not flagged for, well, you didn't go to this school.
Exactly.
Or you didn't have this specific thing.
Which is, yeah, what you're describing is very much how the whole resume analytics world within applicant tracking system works. It's very gameable.
Right.
Which is something I didn't know when I was doing it. I kind of thought, I want this to sound genuine and authentic. But there's websites you can go to and put in the job posting and then put in your resume or your cover letter, and it will tell you how well your keywords match and if you're going to get through those filters.
Yeah.
So we've seen resumes that actually have a bunch of white hidden text in the background with words like Harvard or Yale or, you know, things that are going to help them get through the filter. So there's all this gaming that goes on. With video interviews, you know, that's much more difficult to do. What is good or bad to say really depends on the job,
yeah,
and the company. And then, you know, if people generally do better if they're just being themselves and really expressing themselves. So we use AI, like I said, to kind of sort and kind of help companies see the people who are best fit for the job fastest. So we train our algorithms on people who've previously been in the job and how they ended up doing the job, like sales numbers, retention. We try to predict those things. And when new candidates come in, we sort them in a smart way so that people who display, you know, behaviors and abilities that are that seem like they're going to be a good fit for that job will be seen first. They kind of make it to the top of the pile.
That's awesome. So basically, the moral of the story is don't tell people I went to online school.
Well, no. Dishonesty could be bad, too.
Well, not dishonesty. Just like downplay the
fact. Don't highlight it.
No. Well, thanks so much, Lindsey.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. And again, use hashtag AdobeTT to follow us. And this is a glass box for interviews.